Graduates, I am pleased to welcome you and your family and friends to today's virtual commencement celebration. While I wish we could gather in person for our traditional commencement festivities, I am pleased to be with you virtually to celebrate our graduates and their achievements, and in particular, to recognize the resolve and determination. Benjamin Disraeli, the 19th century British statesman and novelist, once said, "There is no education like adversity." Graduates, you learned this lesson firsthand and over the last year. In the midst of a global pandemic, you have successfully navigated the rigors of higher education and have emerged stronger and wiser and better equipped to tackle the complex issues of our world. Some of you, while pursuing your degrees, also were on the front lines of the pandemic, serving as first responders or as healthcare professionals. You are the true heroes of this pandemic, and we are enormously grateful to you for your devoted service. One such individual, Victoria Fedak, accepts her master's degree in emergency management. She had been a certified EMT only for a few months when the pandemic started. She credits the support she received from her classmates and professors for helping her to persevere. She will continue to help protect the public from COVID-19, as she was recently named the Public Health Emergency Preparedness Coordinator for the Quinnipiac Valley Health District. Another graduate, Sophia Walsh, who accepts her Master of Healthcare Administration, helped ensure COVID-19 testing for associates and implemented contact tracing procedures as part of her internship at Benchmark Senior Living in Hamden. Passionate about working with residents who suffer from dementia, she now works as program coordinator for the facility's memory care community. What has been most inspiring is how our graduates embrace the challenge of learning and working in ways many of us never imagined, and how they persevered and succeeded under the most trying circumstances. Take Emily Morgesi, a member of our honors program, who also earned her bachelor's degree in only 3.5 years. She is excited to dedicate her life to sharing her passion for science with others. A biology major, she served as a microbiology lab assistant, conducted extensive field research, and served as the president of the Tri Beta Biology Honor Society. She is currently applying to graduate programs in biology education. And there is Julian LaRusso, who had already earned two master's degrees, including one in mechanical engineering from MIT, and worked for more than 40 years as an engineer before returning to the classroom to pursue a master's degree in emergency management. As part of his thesis, he researched the potential impact an electromagnetic pulse would have on our nation's critical infrastructure, including transportation systems. He also examined ways to reduce risks for vehicles delivering emergency services and supplies to the public in the aftermath of such an attack. His commitment to being a lifelong learner truly is an inspiration. These are but a few stories of those who excelled in and out of the classroom. Each of our graduates should take great pride. As our future leaders, graduates, you each have a responsibility, one that I encourage you to take very seriously, to be socially conscious, empathetic, and caring individuals. I am confident that you will make your mark on society. As Nelson Mandela once said, education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. I challenge you to be innovators and to have an impact beyond what any of us can envision. Use the knowledge you acquired and the experiences you gained to approach all of your future endeavors with a conviction to leave this planet better than it is today for future generations. I hope that as you begin the next chapter in your lives, that you will remain connected to your alma mater and that you will take great pride in a lifelong affiliation with the university. What gives me great hope is that, like the graduates who came before you, you are equipped with the skills to address the issues that confront us and the problems that we as a society will face in the future. I offer you my heartfelt congratulations and my best wishes for wherever life takes you. Above all, I hope you will never forget, once a Charger, always a Charger. I am now pleased to introduce Daniel Kwiatkowski, who is a finance major and will offer remarks on behalf of the undergraduate student body.
Class of fall 2020, we made it, and what a journey it has been. Before I go on any further, I would like to note that I have no idea how in the world I got chosen to be a speaker at today's graduation. I guess all those ramen noodle meals, early morning classes, hours spent looking for parking on campus, and emails asking professors for deadline extensions really paid off. However, when I was asked to write this speech about 3 weeks ago, I couldn't be more appreciative of the opportunity, and I knew I couldn't let everyone at graduation down. So, just like any term paper or project we've had an entire semester to work on, I got right to the drawing board, and I started working on it the night before it was due. I drank 4 Red Bulls, stayed up all night, hit a mental wall 3 times, submitted my speech 30 seconds before the deadline, and subsequently ruined my sleep schedule for the entire week. I know this is not the picture we all had in our minds when we thought of our big college graduations 3+ years ago as first-year students. None of us thought we would be in the middle of a global pandemic and wearing masks everywhere we go. None of us thought we would be taking classes on Zoom for the last semester and a half. None of us thought we would be watching our graduation from a TV or a laptop. However, while we might not have pictured it this way, we did picture graduating with a hard-earned degree, and that's exactly what we all accomplished. Our time at the University of New Haven has helped us grow and learn. Grow as students, friends, interns, leaders, teammates, researchers, and so much more. And learn about ourselves, who we are, and who we want to be in the future. One of the most important things I learned as an undergraduate here at University of New Haven, especially over the last year, is to never take anything for granted and to appreciate all the small things in life. Let's appreciate that we can graduate from the comfort of our homes with our loved ones right by our sides. Let's appreciate that we don't have to find parking on campus, because that is one of life's most difficult tasks. Let's appreciate all the memories we've made during our time here. And finally, my fellow graduates, appreciate all the work you have done to get those bachelor's and master's degrees. I can sit here and try and think of a clever, motivational quote to end off on and pretend I know what I'm doing or I'm talking about, but truth is, I know just about motivation as a 2-year-old. But what I do know is that we are all here to embark on a journey of our lifetimes and start writing a brand new chapter of our lives. To those graduates that know exactly what their next step is, congratulations. You have worked hard for this moment, and the fruits of your labor will soon begin to manifest. To those many graduates who may not know exactly what you want to do, it's okay. Your journey is just beginning, so enjoy and trust the process, and in due time, your purpose will become clear. Thank you, and congratulations once again, Fall Class of 2020.
Thank you, Daniel. I would now like to welcome Rose Keithan, the president of the Graduate Student Council, who is graduating with a Master's of Business Administration and will offer remarks on behalf of the graduate student body.
Congratulations, Class of 2020. Thank you so much for giving me the opportunity to speak today. As a student body and as a community, over the past year, we have endured insurmountable odds, including the loss of financial stability, the inability to see friends and family, and even the heartbreaking loss of loved ones. Despite all this, we are still here fighting for our education. We have graduates who have flown over 24 hours to obtain their degree. We have graduates that work full-time while supporting a family. And we have graduates that have moved here to be in a more accepting community. And we also have graduates who have lost loved ones here today from COVID-19. And yet again, day in and day out, the students at the University of New Haven continue to push ahead, become resourceful, and find new ways to achieve their goals. I've seen firsthand an adaptation to a new set of norms that entrusts our future to inventive scholars like ourselves. Professor DeGose took these values and directly used them in our online classroom. On days where the last thing I wanted to do was spend 3 hours on Zoom and just hide behind my screen, he encouraged anyone with their camera off to engage in the class. Because of his new set of norms he set in our Zoom classroom, my education wasn't jeopardized. The UNH community is no different, continually evolving to set new standards for high quality education. We motivate ourselves to understand the material despite all the opposing forces surrounding us each day. COVID-19 is just another hurdle our community will overcome and adapt to. But it has also given us great valuable lessons on experiences that we may have never learned without it. Because of this past year, it was our community that taught me the difference between hearing someone and actively listening to them. I implore you after graduation to continue to express your concerns. Stand up against any wrongs, ask for help, and most importantly, make your voices heard. Hard times are undoubtedly upon us, but it is up to us to make the most of it and move forward. Best put by Vivian Green, life isn't about waiting for the storm to pass. It's about learning how to dance in the rain. Thank you and good luck to our new graduates.
I now have the honor of introducing our keynote speaker, Dr. Susan Frampton, the president of Plaintree International, a leading nonprofit that works with organizations around the world to promote patient-centered care as a model for improving the quality of healthcare. Dr. Frampton has been named by Health Leaders magazine as one of 20 people who make healthcare better. A medical anthropologist, she is the vice chair of the World Health Organization's Health Promoting Hospitals Network Governance Board. In 2019, the university's School of Health Sciences became one of the first in the United States to pursue higher education certification from Plaintree International. It gives me great pleasure to introduce Dr. Susan Frampton.
Thank you, President Kaplan. This is such a gift, and it's with real pleasure that I accept this honorary doctorate, not only for myself, but on behalf of so many of my colleagues over the years who have worked alongside me to advocate for the rights of patients and their families and caregivers. I'm even more honored to be with all of you for this milestone in your personal and professional journeys, for a ceremony that celebrates your hard work and accomplishments. And while we would all prefer to be together in person for this celebration, if there's one thing we've learned over the past year, it's been the importance of being flexible and creative in how we continue to connect with one another in safe and responsible ways. But this hasn't been easy. In fact, when I think of each of you and the challenge of completing this milestone in your education, it strikes me that you're graduating during a truly unprecedented moment in history, a once-in-a-lifetime, or perhaps a once-in-many-lifetimes crossroad that not only our country, but the world around us finds itself at. You concluded your studies in a year that many would say has been the worst year ever. How many times have we heard our friends and family say, "I can't wait for 2020 to be over"? But think about this. You will never forget this year or this moment in time. You will tell your children and grandchildren about the year 2020, about a deadly pandemic that spread to every corner of our planet, that required people to wear masks wherever they went. You'll describe to them just how far 6 feet of social distance can feel, what Zoom fatigue meant, and how weary everyone grew of the reminder, "You're on mute." You'll tell them about this virtual commencement ceremony, made necessary just to keep everyone safe, and about the perfect storm that our nation was going through the year that you finished your degree. Not only a pandemic that has claimed hundreds of thousands of our families and friends, but a social justice uprising seeking recognition of hundreds of thousands of other lives that have been impacted through the years based on the inequities woven through our country's institutions and policies. A year in which our country alone racked up a record number of extreme weather events, from droughts and wildfires to cyclones and hurricanes, 16 in total, compared to the 30-year average of 6 to 7 annual events. And to top it all off, perhaps the most divisive presidential election the United States has experienced since Lincoln faced off against General George McClellan in 1864. No, this has not been an easy time. This has not been an easy year, and I imagine you'll not likely forget 2020 anytime soon. But through all of this, with these incredible challenges swirling around you, you somehow stay focused, You stayed committed to your studies and to completing your degree so that you can go out into this world more equipped and ready to use what you've learned to make this a better place. You are an awesome, resilient group of human beings. Your families must be so proud of each of you. And now you're expected to chart your course for what we all hope will be a better future at this time of continuing challenge and uncertainty. More will be asked of you than other graduating classes, because while there is a light at the end of this tunnel we find ourselves in, we're still in the tunnel as the COVID-19 virus continues to fill our hospitals. The divisiveness of our national politics continues to impact the workings of our democracy. Social unrest continues to rock many of our communities, and climate change continues to disturb the very planetary systems we rely on for a healthy, sustainable future. We will need your energy and your light to pull our country through this tunnel and out the other end, because we cannot rely on the generations that created many of these problems to solve them. We will need to look to you. And so today I appeal to you, to your inner drive and dedication, the very things that have gotten you to where you are today, to this singular achievement that against all the odds, you've persevered and made happen. I appeal to your energy, your resilience, and I ask that you not give in to fear, not give in to anger or distrust at a time when it would be understandable to feel these things. I ask that you look ahead for inspiration instead. Can you guess what one of the first things is that people do when they're invited to give a commencement address? They go online and they look at the most inspirational quotes of all time to sprinkle into their comments at just the right point. And so yes, I did that too. And I chose this one that I thought was relevant, particularly at this moment. Don't wish it were easier. Don't wish it were easier. Easier isn't necessarily better. And easier doesn't necessarily bring out the best in people. And besides, we are not living in easy times now anyway. So we all may as well deal with the fact that this is a time that demands more of each of us. This is an unprecedented time that challenges each of us to focus not on those things we can't do because of present circumstances, but on those things we can do. Some of you may be familiar with one of Gandhi's often quoted sayings, "Be the change you want to see in the world." This is your opportunity to be a force for positive change when the world needs that more than ever. I do believe in the power of one person to change the world. Maybe not necessarily on a global scale always like a Gandhi, but each of us, each of you, has an unusual opportunity to be a force for good in a world that desperately needs you and your contributions. You may be wondering, how do I bring out my inner Gandhi? Look around you and you'll find both inspiration and a call for compassion. Look to our fellow citizens who have literally put their lives on the line, including over 1,500 healthcare workers who died this past year as they sought to provide care to patients with COVID-19 before we fully understood how to protect them from the virus. They too faced unimaginable situations and remained committed to the greater good to their patients, even when it put them at significant risk. They are an inspiration. And look to the families of coronavirus victims with compassion, many of whom have had to deal with the grief of not being at the side of loved ones in hospitals and nursing homes in their final days and hours, unable to provide the simple comfort that the presence of a familiar human being brings, struggling now to deal with such loss and continue on with their lives. Look to the many COVID positive patients who chose to forego life-sustaining care in exchange for the healing presence of their families, a decision no one should ever have to make. But these are unprecedented times that have required incredibly difficult choices. I know that some of you have completed degrees in the health sciences, and you will have opportunities to contribute your skills and your knowledge to healing, to the health and well-being of your friends, families, and communities. And if you're looking for additional inspiration, look to those who have used their First Amendment right to free speech thoughtfully and responsibly, finding constructive ways to make their voices heard, supporting needed social change as they strive to create a more fair just and equitable society that extends the same rights and opportunities to everyone, regardless of their race, gender, or national origin. I know that many of you have completed degrees in criminal justice, in forensic science. Your knowledge and expertise will be needed more than ever as our nation strives to chart a course for the future. You will have opportunities to make a difference, to right wrongs, to help us find a path to what our Declaration of Independence set out as a core aspiration of the experiment that became the United States, that all people are created equal, that they are endowed with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. And if you're looking for still more inspiration, look to the innovators who are finding ways to protect both the health of our planet and the strength of our economies, who are pioneering new approaches to renewable technologies and redefining what it means to be a good corporate citizen. Some of you have completed degrees in engineering and in business, and you will have opportunities to find new ways to help the world run as efficiently, effectively, responsibly, and cleanly as possible. And finally, if you're looking for inspiration, look to the record-breaking 160 million Americans who voted in 2020. 22 million more than just 4 years earlier, and the largest number in the history of our presidential elections. I know that some of you have completed degrees in national security, in psychology, and you'll have opportunities to influence the way our country works in the future, to ensure that our society is safe, that our democracy survives and thrives, and that people have access to factual information so that they may make informed decisions. So yes, this past year has been a whirlwind. At times, very sad, very challenging, sometimes disturbing, and yes, some of us have flirted with the idea of moving to Canada, but it's also been an opportunity to step up and be heard, to step up and be helpful, to step up and be counted. And so you each now have both the opportunity and responsibility to write the next chapter, not only for yourself as an individual, but also for our country as we look to our collective future. You can stay in the tunnel of gloom, or you can choose to be a force for positive change. The final line of one of my all-time favorite poems by Mary Oliver asks, "What will you do with this one wild and beautiful life?" You are embarking on the next chapter of your one wild and beautiful life. You get to decide how you spend your precious time. Spend it well. Spend it wisely. Have the courage to pursue your dreams, even in the face of adversity, even at one of the most difficult times in recent history. Lend your talents and your energy and your gifts to making 2021 and beyond memorable for the progress we make in ending this pandemic, for the progress we make to improve equity and social justice, and for finding creative ways to better care for our planet and for one another. And so today I join your families and friends in congratulating you for your educational accomplishment. We're depending on you to go out into the world and help make things better, and for just a little while longer to wear your mask while you do that. Thank you.
Thank you, Susan, for your thought-provoking and poignant remarks. It is now my privilege to present you with an honorary degree.
Susan Frampton, visionary healthcare leader, international expert on person-centered care, passionate patient rights activist. As a medical anthropologist, you have dedicated your life to implementing comprehensive patient-centered models of care as a way to improve the quality of healthcare. The author of three editions of Putting Patients First, Best Practices in Patient-Centered Care, you have developed a critical resource that the founder of a leading international healthcare charity described as a way to revolutionize the work of healthcare professionals and provide far more satisfaction in their work. As the president of Plaintree International for more than 20 years, you have helped the first patient-centered care organization in the U.S. create a global model for enriching and strengthening healthcare practices. Your work as chair of the National Academy of Medicine led to a groundbreaking framework for patient and family-engaged care. You put it best when you say, "At heart, we are people caring for people." Through your advocacy see you truly are an exemplary role model for our students. Susan Frampton, in recognition of your leadership in enriching and transforming how healthcare is delivered, the University of New Haven is proud to confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Humane Arts and Letters, honoris causa.
Susan Frampton, by virtue of the authority vested in me by our Board of Governors, I am pleased to confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters, honoris causa. Congratulations. It is now my privilege to present retired Colonel Merrill Tengestell with an honorary degree.
Merrill Tengestell, trailblazing pilot, decorated military officer, inspirational leader. You have said you were raised to believe there are no limits on what you could accomplish. In every way, you have embraced this mindset. As a student at the University of New Haven in the early 1990s, you were one of only three women in your graduating class to earn a degree in electrical engineering. Following missions in the Middle East, South America, and the Caribbean, and serving as an instructor pilot, you joined the Air Force's U-2 program and took on a courageous new challenge. You became the first and only African-American woman to fly the U-2 spy plane, a high-altitude aircraft used for reconnaissance missions that has been called the most difficult plane in the world to fly. I wanted to challenge myself in ways that had never been done, you said. Don't let anyone tell you that it's too hard. You truly exemplify excellence and empower others to accomplish more than they ever thought possible. Merrill Tengestell, in recognition of your pioneering career and the far-reaching impact you have had in helping others soar to new heights, the University of New Haven is proud to confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Engineering, honoris causa.
Colonel Merrill Tengestell, by virtue of the authority vested in me by your Board of Governors, I am pleased to confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Engineering, honoris causa. Congratulations.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, President Kaplan, Susan, the graduates. I am deeply honored and moved by such a wonderful gesture of an honorary doctorate degree in engineering by a university that has done so much for me in helping me shape my career. When I was asked to give a few words, I'll be honest, I struggled to find something meaningful to say because it's been one hell of a year. A year that has strained every facet of our lives. From the global effects of COVID to domestic events that have made people take to the streets in frustration, anger, and fear, to a 2020 election that still has all of us shaking our heads. I can understand why some of us feel lost, helpless, and incredibly uncertain of what the future may hold. I'm sure our situation will get better, but I'm not able to tell you when that may occur. What I can tell you is all these things that are happening to us have allowed us to become more introspective and realize that we cannot continue on the current trajectory and be successful. These sequences of events have created an appetite of change across the world and for each of us. And that's where you come in as an individual with a fresh perspective, creative ideas, and new skill sets cultivated by your time at UNH. I remember being pushed by my mentor, the late Professor Morrison, to be better than I thought I was. He always challenged me to set my own course and not drift upon the waves. So I challenge you in this dynamic environment to help shape a positive future by creating innovative solutions to help others thrive during this period. You may feel that you're not ready for this, but trust me, you are. Sitting around hoping things will change for the better is not a good strategy. Using the determination and drive that help you succeed here at UNH will bring that challenge and hope to others through whatever endeavors you choose as your life's passion. At first, I doubted that I could make much of an impact. However, I found that as long as I kept moving along the path, the act in itself created change, hope, and opportunity, not only for myself, but for others around me. And this is what I want for you. So thank you very much for a moment to share my thoughts with you. I'm sure you will continue to carry on the traditions of UNH.
Thank you, Merrill. You truly are an inspiration for our students. We will now hear from the deans of our academic colleges, who will present the individual candidates for their degrees.
Thank you very much, President Kaplan. As acting dean of the Henry C. Lee College of Criminal Justice and Forensic Sciences, I want to offer my personal congratulations to all those celebrating their graduation today. You've done it. You've survived. You endured. You succeeded. When I think about the last few years and the experiences you all had to endure in getting through to graduation, I am reminded of a very powerful adage that was best surmised by Zig Ziglar. If you are not willing to learn, no one can help you. If you are determined to learn, no one can stop you. When I think of you who are graduating today, what comes to mind is that determination. Except you not only proved that no one can stop you, you also proved no thing could stop you. You've done what no generation has done in 100 years. You've completed a degree program while amidst a global pandemic. This makes you a very special group, for it means that you truly know the definition of the word persistence. When courses were moved online, you adapted. When schedules were altered, you shifted. When the campus took on an appearance that could best be described as a ghost town, you stayed the course. Through wearing masks, the isolation of quarantining, pickup-only dining, social distancing, and so much more than could possibly be listed here, you persisted and prevailed. And that is a testament to who you are and what you can achieve. To have witnessed this, I am truly grateful, as you have proven that not even a global pandemic can stop a charger with a passion. Whether you are continuing on to graduate school, heading into the workaday world, or still finishing up the vestiges of your bachelor's degree this spring, a chapter in your life is successfully coming to a close. So take the time to celebrate this. You've done something many have not that can never be taken away from you. The world is forever changing, and unfortunately, dealing with COVID-19 was only the beginning. It is very likely that no generation in history will deal with as much societal evolution in such a short time frame as you will. The good news is that you are prepared for these challenges. You have everything you need. And when you feel that you're not headed exactly where you should be, please remember that in a lifelong career, there is no such thing as straightforward, only forward. And you are all ready to go forward. Finally, I have a request. Please never forget that true and honorable public service employs power only when it is tempered by the idea that service above self is its own reward. It is therefore deserving of only your very best efforts. So stay strong, keep seeking answers, and never forget why you came to the Lee College in the first place. Before I turn you over to a member of the Lee College faculty who has a special message for you, I'd like to leave you with one final thought. Some say there are no more heroes. Now is your time to make them realize they've simply been looking in the wrong place. Good luck and congratulations again to the class of 2020. Go Chargers. Thank you.
Hello to my fellow Chargers and everybody joining us today. So you made it to commencement. And though it's not the way we hoped that we could be together, we are here with you, celebrating with you, our graduates, and your families today. When I was asked if I could share a message with you on behalf of the Lee College, my first thought was, this is a little bit of pressure, right? But then I remembered, what we've gone through during the last 9 months together and what we've accomplished during the last 9 months together. And you guys are the ones that have inspired me. I'm actually going to borrow a story, which I think is very fitting, from one of our own in the Lee College. He's one of my favorite faculty members. He's probably one of your favorite faculty members and human beings, if you know him, and that's Marty O'Connor. Marty likes to share a story, which includes advice from his mom that I think is really well suited for our current times and for our Lee College grads. That advice is that anytime there's an emergency, especially one that you're seeing play out in front of you on television, you should not focus on the negative. Instead, you should look for the people who are helping. It's really simple but effective, right? Look for the people who are helping. Don't focus on the panic. Don't focus on the disaster. Look for the helpers. We know that this last year especially, has been something of a slow-moving, drawn-out disaster. But think of all the helpers that you have encountered in that time. Think of everybody that you have seen come together and rally around people to help. These could be people in your life, coworkers, friends, family. It could be medical staff that you've encountered. It could be public servants, police officers, EMS, firefighters, or it could be staff or faculty members from the university. Whoever it is, when you think about the helpers, the perspective changes, and it's not nearly as bad as thinking about the emergency or the disaster itself. But this is the best part about today, and it's really my point in sharing this anecdote with you. Today, we're conferring degrees upon a whole new group of helpers. That's you. You are the helpers. The name of the college may have changed, and many of you in the audience are too young to remember what it was before, but we are, and we always have been, about public service and public safety. And when the helping gets hard, and it will get hard, always remember that we are with you. We are thinking of you, and we are cheering for you. We know that you came to the university with the goal of becoming better public servants. And we know that you have already shown an incredible amount of dedication and perseverance getting through these rough times. I'm convinced if you can make it through 2020, you can make it through anything. So on behalf of the Lee College, I congratulate you, our future helpers. We are extraordinarily proud of your efforts and your accomplishments, and we cannot wait to see your successes in the future. Congratulations, everybody.
Thank you, Professor Torrey, for those inspirational remarks. Mr. President, as Acting Dean of the Henry C. Lee College of Criminal Justice and Forensic Sciences, I have the pleasure of presenting the individual candidates for their degrees.
Brianna Tina Tavares. Amber Sinclair Alston. Isis Arguello. Sedat Temitopa Moyosore Baderu. Casey Ann Bauer. Amber Marie Berlinski. Dualis Castillo. Kiara Angelica Cartagena. Taylor L. Chowns. Jocelyn Roshan Claxton, cum laude. Mark James Conrad. Jessica Rose Conti, magna cum laude. Ahmed A. Davis. Stephanie Nicole Diebolt. Daniel Philip DeRoche. Dana Angelina DeVito. Gabrielle Nicole DiGiacomo, magna cum laude. Alexis Ashley Dolan, cum laude. Samantha Joy Dunham. Ryan R. Durkee. Carrie V. Elvin. Amanda Marie Emmerich, cum laude. Lauren Mary Flig, magna cum laude. Elise Sophia Gerard. Olivia Lee Gould, summa cum laude. Alexis Hall.
Thank you so much to everybody who helped me, my mom, my dad, everybody. Like, you guys made it possible for my son to see me graduate today, and I'm grateful for that.
Allison B. Hanlon, Rancy Heredia, Michael Douglas Huertas, Anisha Kumar, Claudia Renee Lanju, cum laude, Carolyn Ann Linosi, summa cum laude, Erica Levin, Allie Ray Lewis, Jeremy Lopez Bourbon. Corey Jean Lionetti, cum laude. Marissa Mates. Rachel Ann Malone, magna cum laude.
I'd like to thank my family, friends, and professors for supporting me throughout my 4 years at the University of New Haven in pursuing my bachelor's in forensic science.
Kevin John McKenna. Rachel Meyer. Montana Miles, magna cum laude. Allison Dion Morrissey, summa cum laude. Patricia Shelby Nelson. Ariana Padovano. Nicholas K. Fole, cum laude.
2020 is in the books, and so is my college career. Thank you to the University of New Haven for allowing me to pursue my dreams of becoming a law enforcement officer.
Patty Ann Piazza, magna cum laude. Callista Jean Rabatoy, cum laude. Willa Ramdas. Brianna Maria Reynolds. Danielle Jane Rice, magna cum laude. Grace Robinson, summa cum laude. Brandon Christian Ross, cum laude.
I want to give a huge thank you to my family, friends, the faculty at the school, and everybody else who supported me along the way. Got my bachelor's in 3.5 years, and I got my MBA next. Big things are coming.
Darius Roundtree. Kian Michael Rung. Troy Thomas Russell, cum laude. Benjamin Mark Sibilia, magna cum laude. Joanna P. Salati. Vincent Michael Savino, cum laude. Madison Lynn Sheldon. Michael Edward Simons, summa cum laude. Lauren Ann Small, cum laude. Janine Smalling. Kyle Stephen Smith. Ariel Liz Soto. Elizabeth Janet Stalakis, cum laude. Brianna Marie Strayton. Samantha Lee Tice, cum laude. Nita I. Vanasek Cartagena. Alex Wayne Varelis. Diana Darney Villacrisis Poakiza. Jennifer Nicole Vozo, cum laude. Jill Michelle Weber, magna cum laude. Devorah Whitaker. Jonathan R. Woodward. Rachel C. Wynn. Sanika K. Beckford. Imani Carter. Casey E. Clapp. Kurt Anthony Fasulo Jr. Justin Lee Mazzucco. Guanqing Zhou. Faisal Ali S. Al-Wahabi. Crystal Ann Amason. Simran R. Asudani. Allison Bishop. Samantha Nicole Blum. Latasha Kenyatta Boyd. Emily Elizabeth Buds. Brandon Robert Carez. James Joseph Clark Jr. Lindsay Marie Cohen. Perry Silas Cotter. Albert Ray Dancy. Stephanie Liliana DeRoya. Cassandra Lynn Ellison. Victoria J. Fedak. Heather Renee Fontaine. Jake Lewis Getchell. Maria Isabel Gill. Doug Harper. Douglas Bryce Hawkins. Paul Kasten Lawrence. Paul Lucci Jr.
I just want to thank my wife, my daughter, my mom and dad, my sister, my brother-in-law for giving me the confidence to go back to school. Can't believe I'm graduating with my master's. Thank you.
Jonathan Michael Malios. Pamela A. Markham. Latisha Nicole Nelson. Christina Ann Nocito. Elsa E. Nanalea. Allison Ann Oliver. Shayna Noel Presley. Gabrielle Nicole Rich. Nicole Sanka. Allison Nicole Siegel. Joseph Paul Skiffington Jr. John W. Smith. Matthew John Samaji. Catherine Ashley Steele. Simas Urbanavičius. James Timothy Ward. Sharnitra Siobhan Woods.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Governors, I hereby confer on each of our graduates the degree for which you have been recommended and admit you to the rights, honors, and responsibilities of educated individuals. To symbolize your passage into the community of scholars, graduates, please move the tassel on your mortarboard from right to left. I am pleased to welcome you into the university's Alumni Association, a network of more than 60,000 across the country and around the world that is ready to assist you. I realize this is not the culmination of your educational journey that you envisioned when you first stepped foot onto campus. Your resilience, though, and your achievements are what I will remember when I reflect upon your impact on the university. I hope the trials you faced and resoundingly overcame during the course of the last year did not diminish your excitement for reaching this important milestone. You should take great pride in all you have achieved. On behalf of your professors and the entire university community, I offer my best wishes for continued success. And as always, go Chargers.